Today I got a crazy tutorial for you because today we are gonna add movement to a stationary vehicle in Affinity Photo by using some creative blurs. What's up everybody, welcome back to the channel, and if you're new here, my name is Rens. I'm a digital artist from the Netherlands living in a camper, and today we're gonna do something creative. I want to show you a great technique on how to add movement to stationary vehicles. Now we're gonna add two blurs for this. We're gonna add a radial blur and we're gonna add a motion blur to make the wheel spin and to make it seem like the background is actually moving. Alright, are you ready? I definitely am. Let's jump into Affinity Photo. Alright, so we've jumped into Affinity Photo and this is the picture of my camper or car that I want to move. Now, as you can see, this is a stationary picture, so my car was parked when I took the picture, and now I want to add movement to this picture by using different kinds of blurs. Now, there are some preparations that I've done before. So the first one is I masked out my car already because that is quite a tedious job, and well, I don't want to waste your time with that. So I kind of make a very, very rough mask of my car, and now I see that I actually forgot the window, but let's just leave it like it is for now. And the second thing that I've done is I found a new background, and let's place the car on top of this background. So let's zoom in a little bit, and the first thing that I notice is that the shadows of my car are too dark compared to the background. So what I will do first is I will add a levels adjustment layer, and you can also do this with curves or anything like that, but I will go for a levels adjustment layer in this case. So I hit Command L, I clip it to the car layer, so I clip it right over here, and then I will just decrease the output black level a little bit so that the car matches the background better. So this is the before and this is the after, and as you can see, it already kind of matches a little better with the background. Now you can also see there's a shadow missing, so if we want to, we can add a shadow right now. So let's maybe do that. So I'm gonna create a new pixel layer right over here. I'm gonna grab a soft round brush. I'm gonna select black as a foreground color, and yeah, I'm gonna make it easy for myself. I will just make one stroke. So I click once right over here, I shift click at the top right over here. There I have one stroke, and now this is on a separate pixel layer, so I can move this thing around. This is not gonna be the most realistic shadow, but yeah, I kind of need a shadow, so let's just put it beneath the car. So maybe something like this. We can drag it all the way here, and there we have a shadow. Now, as mentioned, this is not a tutorial on how to make the most realistic shadows. I know there are way better methods for this, but this does the job for this image. All right, so let's drag this one in a little bit, and there we go. Now is the fun part, or now is when the fun part begins. So what I want to do is I basically want to make it look like the wheels are actually spinning. But before we do that, I want to isolate the wheel on its own layers, and actually both wheels, because you can see this wheel right over here. Actually, let's reduce the opacity a little bit of the shadow, so something like this. You can see the wheel right over here. It is overlapped by this little thing. So I'm gonna cut off this wheel. I'm gonna like extract this wheel as well. And then we're gonna use this blur. So let's make a copy of this image. So I'm gonna press Command J with this selected. I'm gonna hit the right mouse button and I'm gonna click on Rasterize, because I need to have this as a pixel layer and this is still an image layer. And what I want to do now is make a selection of this wheel. So I'm gonna use my pen tool for this because it's quite easy. So I'm just gonna select this, make a quick selection of this wheel. So something like this.
Hey, real quick, if you've been getting value out of this video already, then don't forget to like this video. And of course, if you want to support the channel and you want to learn more Affinity Photo, hit the subscribe button. All right, let's jump back into the tutorial.
And that looks pretty good to me. So we're gonna hit on selection right at the top here, and I'm gonna press Command X, and then I'm gonna press Command V. And now you can see that we've got the wheel on its own layer. So we actually cut it off our pixel layer. Now we're gonna do the same for this one, and maybe I can use this wheel to make a selection of that wheel as well. So I'm gonna press Command J to duplicate this one, and I'm gonna drag it over to this side, and you can see that these wheels actually match quite well. So I'm gonna press Command and then hit this pixel layer to make a selection. And now I want to cut off the top. So I'm gonna use the polygonal lasso tool for this. I'm gonna hold Alt and I'm gonna click right over here and then to the other side, and then go all the way around to subtract this from my selection. And now you can see I've got the wheel selected. So same thing, I can go to my pixel layer. I'm gonna press Command X and then I'm gonna press Command V. Now press Command D to deselect, and now this should be on its own layer, as you can see. All right, now this wheel, I'm not gonna need it anymore, so I'm gonna select it and press Delete. And let's rename our layer. So this is gonna be the front wheel. Then we got the rear wheel, and yeah, these both things are camper. So let's say camper, and this is also camper. All right, let's press Command 0 to zoom out. And what I want to do now with the front wheel is I want to add a radial blur. So I'm gonna go to my live filters right over here. I'm gonna select radial blur and zoom in a little bit on the wheel. And now when I increase this, you will see that we get this really, really weird blur. And that is because the pivot point is gonna be the center or the anchor point. So what I want to do is I want to move the pivot point to the center of the wheel. So I'm gonna click right over here on the wheel. And now I'm gonna increase the radius. And now you can see that we actually get this, the effect that the wheel is actually spinning. So let's do that on the rear wheel as well. So I think this looks pretty good. Now it looks like it's going pretty fast. So let's cross this one off. Let's go to the rear wheel and let's add a radial blur here as well. So I'm gonna go to the live filters and hit radial blur. And now I want to do the same, but this time I want to make sure I'm in the center of the wheel. So not in the center of the half of the wheel. So I'm gonna click somewhere around here and then I'm gonna do the same. So I'm gonna increase the radius. So something like this looks pretty good to me. Well, let's go for the same radius as the other one. So around 60, and there we go. Now you can see that it kind of overlaps right over here, and I'm not really sure how we can fix this. Maybe we can hit preserve alpha, and there we go. So when we preserve alpha, we remain the same shape of our rear wheel, let's say. All right, so now we have our wheels turning. This already looks pretty cool. I see that my front wheel is a little bit too big, so let's resize this one a little bit. So there we go. And what I want to do next is I want to add movement to the background image as well. So now you can see it's a stationary image, but we're gonna add a motion blur. So I'm gonna go to my background pixel layer. I'm gonna go to my live filters and I'm gonna go to motion blur. And now I want to have the motion blur from left to right, or let's say 0 degrees or 180 degrees, doesn't really matter. And I'm gonna increase the radius quite a bit. And I want to increase the radius so much that I kind of match the speed of the wheel. So this is just guessing and just doing what looks good, but this looks pretty cool to me actually. And when we cross it off, you can see we already have this very nice motion blur in our image. Now, we can also add some motion blur to the shadow as well if we want to. So let's do that. Let's go to our shadow. Let's actually rename this. And let's add a motion blur right over here as well. You can already see it's kind of blurred, but let's add some motion blur to the shadow just to indicate that we're going super, super fast.
Thank you so much for watching this tutorial. And if you want to see more creative Affinity Photo content, then check out this video right over here, because YouTube says that you will love it. All right, thank you so much and I'll see you in the next one. Ciao, ciao.